So the Mutant Drop Zone is finally here. We developed months on this feature and finally it's ready for the past week. It has been online, and if you were introduced to it by a friend, or if you got it from our webpage, this is the video to watch if you want to understand what the Mutant Drop Zone is all about. It's basically a better airdrop. Airdrop is, in a way it works, but it doesn't really work. And also it only works if you're in the same room, which is a problem if you're not in the same room. For example, this computer, which is not connected to this computer by any means, other than both of them are in the internet, could be in Tokyo for all I care. Let me show you how easy it is and what it can do. So here I've got a picture and I simply drag and drop it onto something we call a contact bubble, or like a drop zone, and that's the name of the feature. And I drop it, and on this computer, the picture appears. This is a 3 megabyte picture. Let me show you how fast that is again by dragging it back to the computer on top, and the picture is back. Let me do it again with this picture that I got right here. I drag and drop on the drop zone and the picture appears on this side, and I can immediately use it and put it anywhere I want. For example, I put it here into the browser, show you this is the real deal. I now drag it out of the browser again onto the bubble to show you it immediately appears on the other side again, and I can use it here. And the way it works is that the computer that's receiving the content is actually giving permission to the other computer. You do that by going to Mutant. You have your Mutant bubble here. We all know that. This is what's being installed. Once Mutant installed, you can see the bubble. You click on it and something called the remote control opens, which includes all the folders you might have created. And there's a new small tab on top, which is called the contacts. And in here, if you want somebody else to be able to drop to you another Mutant user, you add a contact, you add their username, you have to know the username, just press return, and now they can create a drop zone on their side. For example, in this case, I added Zeus7 into my contacts, and this computer here is running Zeus7 Mutant, and they have Zeus6 in their contact list, and that's the account above. So this computer now, by right mouse clicking on the Mutant bubble, you can create a drop zone to Zeus6. I go to the bubble, I say use a drop zone, then I go to Zeus6, now the bubble appears. I can drag this bubble anywhere on the screen. It always floats on top, so if it's annoying for you, simply close it. But it's a very cool shortcut to that computer running Mutant. In this case, I would take this picture, drag it onto this, and you immediately see it appearing here, and now I can use it here to drag and drop it back towards the other computer, and it's back. That's how AirDrop should have been, but AirDrop only works in the same room. This works anywhere in the world where two computers have Mutant installed. You can build a bridge and transfer content just like this. Right now, it only works with pictures, but how does it work? Oh my God. Take a look at this. This is a 40 megabyte picture, and I can take that picture and drag it to the other computer. Normally you would take a WeTransfer link or Google Drive or an intranet or anything else, like, or you put it on a USB stick to transfer that. But now you can simply take the picture, I drag and drop it towards the bubble, and on the other side it appears within seconds. This is a 40 megabyte picture. I just transfer it from computer to computer. And that's pretty amazing considering that right now, this is absolutely not possible. So in the next months, we will add different file types. We will add PDF files. We will add video files, especially we're thinking about TikTok videos and Instagram videos, short reels, like anything between 50 and 200 megabytes. Think about Photoshop files that sometimes are 400 megabytes big. And normally, in order to transfer them, again, you need something like WeTransfer. You need to create a link. But now you simply drag and drop it onto a bubble of your friend. You can create those drop zones as many as you want. And so if you want somebody else to be able to exchange content with you like this, you have to tell them, go to the Mutant homepage, download the client, create a username. And in the moment they have a username, you can do this. In that moment, you can send them content like this. And within the next months, we will add all content types. For example, one of the major features that I love so much is I go to Pinterest or to Google Picture Search and I wanna transfer these pictures to somebody else. Like I'm looking for something for somebody else. Simply drag them out of here onto the bubble, and you can see on this side, the picture appears on the other computer. You don't have to download it, put in a download folder, then make an email and upload it or retransfer. You simply take a picture, no matter how big, and you drag and drop it towards somebody else by dragging it onto their contact bubble. And that's it. Welcome to a brave new world. stay tuned. Go to our Instagram page, follow us for new updates. Go to our YouTube channel where we try to publish every week a few videos that describe in detail how Mutant tools can change the way you interact with multimedia. And we also give insights into our development process. We're a small startup from Munich. We're very proud of the technology that we created because nothing like this exists in the world. We would love to be in contact with you. Just drop us a line, drop us a comment, drop us a comment on Instagram too, or just send us an email, or my telephone number is actually there. Like, you can call me, and like, you can send me a message on WhatsApp and simply tell me, hey, this is what I think of those tools. We wanna communicate with you guys and see what else you guys need in order to make your multimedia journey more comfortable when dealing with Macintosh. But let's for now just enjoy the possibility that finally what you see in science fiction movies, you can actually do, is simply drag and drop.